The grading of GCSE result is changing from A star to G to 9 to 1. The aim of the new grading system is to allow greater differentiation between higher and lower achieving students. The first new GCSE for the 9 to 1 grade are Maths and English from 2017, followed by all the others over the next 2 years. We ask Longhill High School what they think about those changes.
As teachers, we've been introducing this with the students probably for the last 2 years when they first started to be implemented. They began in September 2015 and we've been supporting the students and the parents and giving out information and talking to them, making them understand what the changes are, working with them with the work that they do in class, you know, for exam questions and practice papers and specimen papers in order for them to progress. They're learning more curriculum or subject and gaining more knowledge. As far as it being fair that they've got more difficult, I think the government's plan is that they are supporting young people to be able to compete in a global market.
I think the disadvantage would be maths, of course, in my opinion, because I've always struggled with maths. But with English, in my opinion, I didn't see much change. But the only change there was the fact that we have to learn 15 poems by heart, only one of it being in the exam, which is kind of hard, yeah.
The main advantage, we've now got more grades to gain, and there is an opportunity for that grade 9, that top grade, is going to be accessed by maybe 3%.
I think one of the benefits is that there are more grades now, there are two more grades that you can achieve, so it's more specific, but I think one of the problems with that is that parents and people who aren't in schools anymore don't know what's going on, they can't exactly understand it so easily. One of the sort of disadvantages, one of the things that I don't so much understand about it is why it's been brought in. It could have just continued as it was and I don't think it would have made much of a difference to me personally.
Of course, like the bright students, they'll probably find everything easy, but like the kids that don't find it easy, I think they should focus on them a bit more, because they just focus on the bright students and they'd want them to get into good universities like Oxford or something, so Cambridge, so it's all different.
I think change is difficult whenever you do it, so I think that they could have staggered it over 5 years or 10 years, but they're staggering it over maybe two, and you know, the sooner we get used to it, the sooner we move on, the sooner we carry on supporting our young people, and then, you know, in a handful of years we'll be looking back and we will know no different. So you know, whilst we're dealing with the challenges of the change and the quick change, in the long run it's probably better for our young people.
I think it is somewhat unfair, but I don't think you could really do it in many other ways. I think that's the only way you could try something in school is to go straight to a school and do it.
I don't think all grades should be 1 to 9 because people don't understand what they are yet. So like a 4 could be like a low C or a high C.
For me it would be better if it was rolled out across all subjects, because currently I've got a lot of subjects that are sort of 1 to 9s, and then my graphics, for example, that's still A to G. So it's a bit confusing trying to work out where you are on each scale.
This is Ulrich Ranieri for Latest TV News.